Hi, I'm Madison Binnick, and welcome to Movies to Watch on a Rainy Afternoon. Before we start today's film review, however, I'd like to first partake in the traditional rainy afternoon movie viewing snack.
Nobody likes me, everybody hates me, guess I'm going worms. Nobody likes me, everybody hates me, guess I'm going worms.
Let's take a look at today's feature. This disgusting dreck of a feature film centers around a man named Herman Umgar who breeds hordes of worms in an old windmill house on the banks of his dried-up lakeside property. Umgar is played by writer-director Herb Robbins, who apparently thought that making a movie featuring a club-footed hermit protagonist who communicates with worms was a good idea.
Doesn't get tangled up like last Thursday. No, everybody. Let me see. Oh, the nose is cold. Ah, that's good. The head's cold. Yeah, everybody. Eddie, inside. Wait a minute. No, you're healthy. You're okay. You too. Let me see the feet. Yeah, you're okay.
Where did a movie like The Worm Eaters even come from? Would it be a stretch to imagine the original negative burrowed up from the depths of soaked soil during a rainstorm and nearly squished under the feet of unsuspecting moviegoers? I can only imagine how the filming of this movie transpired. Yeah, just leave the camera rolling. I'll sit here and play with these worms all fucking afternoon. We've got a movie here, folks! Why would I want to hang out with this guy for 90 minutes? He builds fucking model houses for worms! Enduring a film like The Worm Eaters is about as exciting as scraping wet worm guts off from the soles of your shoe. But at least it has a catchy opening credits theme song.
Nobody likes me, everybody hates me, guess I'm going worms. Nobody likes me, everybody hates me, guess I'm going worms.
Who drew these opening credit title cards and why? I picture a kindergartner on an acid trip, got themselves a handful of crayons, went to town doodling worms, and composing a portrait of a son that's way too happy to be a son. The dental hygiene, or lack thereof, for this worm family must have fallen to the wayside due to the vacant sink countertop. Where's their toothbrushes? Or bottles of Scope even? For a family of parasites who spend all day chowing down on dirt, they sure don't seem to take care of themselves. The film opens on a group of fishermen camping outside. Only we have to first sit through a solid 10 seconds of fireside belching. Stay classy, worm eaters.
We've been fishing for 2 days in this hell of a lake and we ain't caught a draft. You do that one more time, I'm gonna tear the tongue out of your head from the roots and slap you to death with it. I'm trying to sleep, and I can't sleep with you belching. If I can't sleep, I can't get me that championship bass in this here pond.
Just shut the hell up and eat some worms already.
Heard me the sound of worms. Are you sure, Bucky? Sure, I'm sure. I know the sound of worms. Hell, I can hear a tapeworm in the hall.
We randomly cut from the fishermen to what is quite possibly the saddest and most depressing birthday party I've ever seen. These children couldn't possibly look any less enthused.
I want you to cut the cake, but first, you gotta blow out all the candles and make a good wish.
I wanna cut the cake, Ursula, just the way I cut up your doll.
Give me back the knife, I'll beat the crap out of you.
Dad, she said she was going to beat the crap out of me.
If you don't give me back the knife, I'll beat the crap out of you and anybody else that tries to stop me from cutting my cake.
Now, you don't really mean that, sweetheart.
The crap I don't.
She said crap again.
I know she said crap again. Give her the knife.
Listen, kids, if you don't cut that goddamn cake, I'm going to kick the crap out of both of you.
Yeah, give me the knife or I'll beat the crap out of you.
She beat the crap out of me and you don't even get her crap. She beat the crap out of...
The film aims for laughs, even advertising itself as a comedy, but it's not very amusing or fun at all for that matter.
Look, Daddy, a surprise! That they're doing!
You would think a movie entitled The Worm Eaters would be a real gross-out, over-the-top, entertainingly hysterical feature film, but it's not, and the PG rating suggests that it was intended for a juvenile audience.
You got bullcock?
Bullcock? Oh, what's a bullcock? How come everybody in this country is here longer than me and nobody speak English? Now, look, you talk slow, and then you say in plain American, okay? Now, what do you want?
It's American English, bullcock for toilet.
Toilet's a water, and a handle is a toilet. You know what do you say?
Do you want a bullcock for your toilet? Is that what you're trying to say, sir?
Yeah, plain American speech, bullcock for toilet.
It's the round thing that goes up and down.
Oh, you mean the water ball that goes up and a down, up and a down.
No go up and down, no up and down, bullcock. English for toilet.
What's the matter? Nobody around here gonna speak English?
Was any of that funny or relevant to anyone? The only people who would have found that scene amusing are two animated delinquent teenagers.
He said,
bullcock.
Umgar finds himself the center of attention when a gold-digging temptress attempts to seduce the marble-mouthed bug lover. Allegedly, the land Umgar inherited from his father after his death is worth all kinds of big bucks, and she wants herself a piece of that action. And what do her seductive techniques entail? Well, we're about to find out.
See what the boys in the back room will have, and tell them I cry, and tell them I sigh, and tell them I'll have your say.
I've been going about this whole dating scene the wrong way. Apparently all I need to pick up women are dirty jean overalls, a limp, and a collection of creepy crawlers. Umgar takes his newfound companion back to his worm-riddled bang shack, thus beginning one of the strangest dinner date sequences in a film I've ever seen. First of all, she doesn't even try to cook for him. Instead, she rummages through his cupboards and prepares a snack made up of his own chips and dip. Gee, thanks. You really shouldn't have.
I want to be in pictures. I want to be a star. Now, what did you fix yourself for lunch today? Let's see what to be happening here. Wow! Marbles! Oh my God, they're horrible, horrible, ugly! They look like Chinese food! I hate Chinese food!
After Heidi's Chinese food freakout, Umgar takes dinner into his own hands.
I'm going to cook good spaghetti dinner. Yeah, Italian spaghetti. Learned how to cook spaghetti from old Italian garbage collector that I learned cooking from. Nice Italian men teach me to cook Italian food and to speak Italian, honey. He teach me to say, hope you pasta, honey.
And we all know those old Italian garbage collectors sure can prepare a mean plate of pasta.
Ready to see the new transformed Heidi? Here I am, ready to face my man. Well, how do I look? All pretty for my man again, huh?
Yeah.
Skull!
Somebody better start eating worms soon or I'm gonna lose patience. Seriously, they're right there! Run over and stuff some in your annoying fucking face and shut the fuck up! Finally, the Worm Eaters lives up to its title when Heidi chows down on her grub. Literally. Filmed in disgusting graphic close-ups of her meal writhing about the side of her mouth. Umgar doesn't stop at Heidi, though. Oh no. He hits the town, attempting to feed nearly everyone he can the creatures from his homebred worm farm. However, the close-ups of people eating worms are obviously inserts of stand-ins who were brave enough to put the slimy critters in their mouths. You can tell the actors the stand-ins were attempting to portray are entirely different people due to the phony mustaches pinned to their face. Did the makeup department cut the bristles off of an ice scraper brush and glue them to this actor's upper lip? Well, turns out that Umgar's been busy breeding some kind of mutant worms due to the fact that after consumption, his hapless victims transforms into beeping wereworms that don dirty brown sleeping bags, excrete whipped cream, and crawl around on the floor like imbeciles. One of the odder trademarks found within the Worm Eaters, aside from the worm eating and wereworm transformations, of course, are the pervasive references to America, hot dogs, and hot dogs being the American food stereotype proudly shoved down our throats.
You got any hot dogs in there? Even a crummy place like this pigsty's gotta have hot dogs.
No hot dogs. Hot dogs got sawdust in them, bad for stomach.
Hey, Shorty, don't you know that it's un-American not to have hot dogs?
If you're going to live here and serve food to us American youth, then it's your patriotic duty to have hot dogs.
Not wieners, you understand? Plain American hot dogs. We're going to report you. They're going to take you to the Mexican border and throw you out.
Can you imagine that? The old clubfoot might get sent back to Berlin because he doesn't know about hot dogs.
I heard they were going to take the eagles off the flagpoles and put hot dogs up there. Sexy.
No hot dogs. Umgar's menu only bologna sandwich costs $1.
Oh, far off.
Wow, look at these hot dogs. Oh, wow.
Mustard and everything.
Woo.
What is it with hot dogs in America? I just don't get it. Ooh. Even the hand-drawn opening credit title cards depict worms wrapped around the American flag and inserting themselves into hot dogs. I sincerely hope foreigners who watch this movie aren't influenced by the warped mind of Herb Robbins and come to some kind of conclusion that we Americans prefer our food slimy yet satisfying. Thanks, worm eaters, for portraying us Americans as a group of disgusting insect eaters, because nothing is more American than eating larvae that's wrapped around our food. The climax of the film arrives when Umgar is awoken with a fish hook in the neck, courtesy of a gang of worm men who have come to claim the worm women he has been hoarding in his attic for their presumable worm orgy. You guys would probably move a lot faster if you just took off those goddamn sleeping bags. God. This scene makes me feel like I'm watching something from Deliverance. Only instead of a gang rape type situation, there's a grown man being force-fed worms. While Umgar is busy transforming himself, his wereworms break free and wreak havoc on the town.
Now remember, kids, no peeking in the pantry till tomorrow morning. Daddy'll be home from his business trip tomorrow night. It's his birthday, you know. And I made his favorite jam, kumquat jam. That's what I made, all right. Kumquat jam. What a horrible name for a fruit. Kumquat.
What a horribly acted scene to feature in the final few minutes of a movie. The film comes to a close when Umgar is released into the world now fully transformed and has a close encounter with a semi-truck barreling down the road. I guess if one were to be flattened like roadkill after becoming half man, half worm, why not have it be by a trucker who eats fruit before removing the peel and flexes after discarding aforementioned snack out the window? Who the fuck was the core audience for a film like this? Newborn baby birds? Young children who bide their time during recess, knuckles deep in the dirt, scouring for a wriggling snack to scarf down? I can goddamn guarantee there isn't a single person out there who is ever going to mutter the phrase, "Nobody likes me, everybody hates me, guess I'll go watch the Worm Eaters." Fuck this movie.
Nobody likes me, everybody hates me.